我叫刘晓勇，我从中国安徽，安徽 China， 我教他们是中国话，我是在中国学的，我学话是50年。中国话是分，中国话它分花鸟、山水、人物，我教的是花鸟和山水，这个是，这是花鸟，这叫花鸟画。这个是池塘、荷塘，荷塘里有一个翠鸟。夏天的荷塘，这是荷叶，这是荷塘的芦苇。然后这个翠鸟呢，待在这个荷梗和这个荷叶的梗上面，正在看着这个蜻蜓。这是按中国人讲就是一种恬静的情趣，就是很安静的一个池塘。这呢就是山水画，中国画的山水。这个画的是一个初冬，就是刚刚到冬天，所以它开始下雪了，但是这个树上的叶子呢还有一点，这是冬天的景色，就带了，主要是这两个，还有一个也是花鸟，这是，樱桃，樱桃熟了，樱桃熟了，这个鸟在这想吃这个樱桃，这个下个月教这个画展呢，主要是我教的这些小孩，有23个小朋友，他们是，这是他们的课堂作业。就是我在上课时教的画的什么，他们就画的内容，大概有40多幅，我是到 Quincy 以后，我是2009年，到 Quincy 以后，然后就开始教这个小朋友，大概是10年，教的第一个小朋友呢，就是在外面的叫他叫林婉婷，就是等一下他会进来，他有一张书签，就是我们在图书馆办第一次画展，用他的书签，用他的画做的书签做纪念品发的，他是跟我学了6年画，我们在图书馆呢一共是办了1次、2次、3次，这是第4次画展。我做这个画展呢，是因为一个呢是宣传一下中国的这个传统的文化，我们用我们教的这个中国山水画呢是很传统的，它和现代的中国山水画是不一样的，中国画是不一样的，所以它是一种很传统的中国画。第二个呢，就是在昆西呢有很多中国人，他中国人有很多小孩他们想接触一点中国的文化，了解一下中国文化的背景，所以呢他们有很多小孩喜欢这个中国画，我就来教他们，教过以后呢就想办一个画展呢，让他们看看他们自己的成果，因为他们很多小孩呢有的是学画很长，学了6年，他们还有的小孩呢很短，才学了半年，但是呢他们从不会拿毛笔，这是因为中国画一个很特别的，就是他用的是毛笔、宣纸、墨三个最主要的工具，他用不会拿笔、不会写中国字开始，然后到现在可以画出一幅完整的画，而且可以把他的字名字用中文把它写出来，我认为这个对他们来讲是一个不小的成果，所以我想把这个他们的成果展现给大家看一下。
My name is Xiaoyong Liu, and I'm Chinese, but I don't understand Mandarin because I speak Cantonese, but he teaches in a way that you can understand him, and he does it step by step. There's this August Moon Festival they hold in Quincy every year by Corey, and one year he had a stand there, and my mom wanted me to give it a go, and then I really like art, so then I decided to take classes with him.Lately, we've been painting flowers that are red or pink and white, and they'll have butterflies around them or dragonflies. every time there's going to be some Chinese characters describing what the piece is about. I just do it as a hobby, like take some time off of school when it's like in fall. You should try it, like even if you don't understand what he's necessarily saying, it's still really fun and he'll take his time to help you.
I am Roger Wong. First, my mom said, oh, Roger, you like art, so might as well like let you try to do this. And I was like, okay, give it a go. And then I just started. I didn't really know what he was saying because I'm not fluently in what he's saying. So it was kind of confusing, but then he kind of helped me out. And then like after just watching what he does, you just follow along. Some of them will be with flowers, plants, different animals, very elegant. And they will have descriptions next to it with Chinese and names who painted it. The different colors that contrast with each other, it makes the paintings really pop out and look really nice. It may be challenging at the beginning, but after classes go on, you will it will get easier and better to paint different things, and it will be a lot more joyful.
My name's Emily Zoe. Before, I liked drawing, and my mom was just asking me if I wanted to go to the class, and I was like, okay, I'll try it out. It helps me with my Chinese and my Chinese writing. I like painting like bright ones, like maybe some bright trees and stuff. I'm gonna probably put up another one, which is like one with trees and these blossoms. My mom is really close to our friend and his son. He paints with us.
Kylie, so my mom knew I liked art, so she brought me to the painting class, and I was like, asked me if I want to go there, and I was like, sure. I like to paint fishes and flowers. Well, I copied the teacher, because he usually writes it on the board and we copy it off like on our own piece of paper. We painted fishes and like one with a Santa Claus on it.
Alice Xiao. So when I was in China, I wanted to learn Chinese painting. So I learned it for a year and I come to here. And my mom find a new Chinese painting class for me, so I go to the flower and birds. The teacher gonna be show us the steps of the like the flowers, and then we draw it. And then he'll write the words down and then we copy it down.
Paco Lam. I wanted to do it when I was little, but I did Kung Fu, so I moved a lot. So then the teacher thought I would move around in the class. But then he said I can join the class when I'm older, so I joined it when I'm older. It helps me concentrate on making my animes. I do that and I draw animes. Animes is Japanese cartoons. I have one right there. It's two birds and a lot of flowers. I'm nervous, but I'm also happy.